Okay, so we discussed about all this. Okay, I hope everybody has written. Now somebody, I think, who had the doubt? कोई doubt पूछ रहा था मेरे से अभी? व्रज? आपको doubt था कुछ?
नहीं सर, वो लिख रहा, बाकी था वो लिख लिया।
ओके ओके ठीक है, चलो ये लिख लिया सबने इतना।
नहीं सर, बाकी था।
लिखो लिखो। तो इफ यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ फाइनाइट डिस्प्लेसमेंट, देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट दैट यू कैन हैव। वन इज वेरी इनफाइनेटली स्मॉल डिस्प्लेसमेंट, मतलब ये इतना पास में है, इतना पास में है दोनों पॉइंट्स, ठीक है, बहुत पास पास में है दोनों पॉइंट्स, ये पॉइंट और ये पॉइंट, इनके बीच का डिस्टेंस इज डी एस, ठीक है, इन टर्म्स ऑफ वेक्टर इट इज डी एस वेक्टर। बट इसको तुम अगर मैक्रोस्कोपिकली देखोगे तो ये बहुत पास पास में रहेंगे। आ रही बात समझ में? Is this clear now? But when I say finite displacement means this is point A and this is point B. Point A and point B. This is finite. So in case of finite displacement, what you need to do is you have to integrate this expression, because the value of electric field may not be same throughout the path of its travel. अगर वो इस पॉइंट से, ठीक है, सपोज करो वो इस पॉइंट से इस पॉइंट ए से इस पॉइंट बी तक अगर जब वो मूव कर रहा है इस पाथ के अलावा, क्योंकि मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड हियर एंड हियर विल बी डिफरेंट। यहाँ पे इधर हो सकती है, इधर इस डायरेक्शन में हो सकती है, राइट? सो इफ मैग्नीट्यूड इज चेंजिंग देन दैट मींस वी नीड टू इंटीग्रेट इट फॉर स्मॉल स्मॉल एलिमेंटल पार्ट्स। छोटे छोटे डिस्प्लेसमेंट हमको यहाँ पे देखने पड़ेंगे, ठीक है, यहाँ से लेके यहाँ तक एक डिस्प्लेसमेंट, यहाँ पे इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड क्या थी, व्हाट इज द वर्क डन, फिर वो वर्क डन को हम लोग हर छोटे छोटे एलिमेंट के लिए ऐड करते जाएंगे। कितने एलिमेंट्स होंगे? इनफाइनाइट एलिमेंट्स होंगे। सो दैट प्रोसेस हैज टू बी अप्लाइड एंड दैट प्रोसेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स इज नथिंग बट योर इंटीग्रेशन, ठीक है। अब आप इसको लिख लीजिए। यस आई थिंक सबने लिख लिया होगा. इसमें जो लिमिट्स है वो पॉइंट ए से पॉइंट बी है. दैट मींस व्हेन यू कैलकुलेट दिस इंटीग्रल यू डू हैव टू कंसीडर द पाथ बट द रिजल्ट दैट यू विल ऑब्टेन विल बी पाथ इंडिपेंडेंट. यू विल गेट द रिजल्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इनिशियल एंड फाइनल दिस थिंग. ठीक है चलिए अब नेक्स्ट करते हैं. So let me explain the points first, then you can write it down. Now the potential energy per unit charge, U by Q naught. Okay, now just recollect your knowledge of 11th standard gravitation chapter, that when you calculated gravitational potential, it was defined as work done in bringing a unit mass from infinity to that given point. Okay, so that work done by the external agent is stored as the potential energy, gravitational potential energy of the system. Okay, now if you calculate that gravitational potential energy per unit charge, per unit mass, it becomes gravitational potential of that point. Okay, so even if, let's say that is the point, ये एक पॉइंट है पी. अब मैं इन्फिनिटी से एक मास को लेके आ रहा हूँ इस पॉइंट तक, तो द वर्क डन एट दिस पॉइंट, द वर्क डन एट दिस पॉइंट, व्हेन आई से वर्क डन इन ब्रिंगिंग दैट मास फ्रॉम इन्फिनिटी टू दिस पॉइंट पी, राइट, विल बी समथिंग डब्ल्यू. If I divide this by mass m naught, it gives me the potential of this point. In the same fashion, the electric potential energy are correlated. I mean, not correlated, but they are analogous. Okay, so that same kind of definition, the same wave definition is there. Okay, so I'll just read out the potential energy. Per unit charge, U by Q naught is independent of the value of Q naught. Okay? And has a unique value at every point. Okay? Now, it does not say anything about the charge. It says that at every point, there is a unique value of electric potential. Okay? That point should lie in the electric field. If there is non-existent electric field, that means the point is far, far away from the charge distribution. Or you can consider that point to be infinity, at infinity. So if there are no electrical effects at that point, then if there are no electrical effects at that point, we will consider the potential of that particular position to be zero. This is what we choose as a convention. And if I bring that unit test positive charge from infinity to that particular point in space where electric field is present, then that work done per unit charge will be the potential of that point. Okay, so that same way it is defined. Instead of mass, now you are using the term unit test positive charge. Okay, now you just write down everything. I hope everything will be clear. ठीक है, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, बट इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज स्केलर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, ओके, ऑफ दैट सेम इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. ओके, नाउ इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द चार्ज. Electric potential is independent of the charge, right? The charge that you bring in from infinity to that point, उस charge के magnitude पे depend नहीं करता है. It is the property of the charge distribution in its surrounding. Is that clear? Suppose करो ये एक point है P, ठीक है, और इसके पास में यहाँ पे नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस आते हैं. नाउ यू कैलकुलेट द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दिस पॉइंट पी बाय ब्रिंगिंग अ यूनिट टेस्ट पॉजिटिव चार्ज फ्रॉम इंफिनिटी. नाउ द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दिस पॉइंट इज अ स्केलर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड प्रेजेंट एट दिस पॉइंट. यहाँ पे जो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड है उसका फंक्शन है ये. इट डज नॉट इन एनी वे डिपेंड ऑन द चार्ज ब्रॉट इन to calculate the work done. That is just for the theoretical purpose. The potential of this point is merely a function of the electric field at this region, in this region. Okay? So electric potential is a scalar characteristic of an electric field which is independent of the charges that may be placed in the field. Okay, उस field में अगर हम कोई और charge रखते हैं तो वो charge force experience करेगा. That charge cannot affect the potential of that particular point. ठीक है, but whenever we talk of potential energy, okay, if we talk of potential energy, then it is defined for the entire charge field system. Then it is defined for the entire system. It is not for a point or for a single charge. At least two charges, two point charges will be present. Then only we will call that as having a potential energy. That potential energy is not associated with one particular point charge. It is associated with the entire field system. Okay? There is generally a misconception in the students. So let me just clarify one more time. Okay. So when we talk of gravity, okay, there is no need to write all this. When we talk of gravity, we treat this as the surface of Earth as having potential to be zero, which is not. हम लोग इसको relatively इसको reference मान के इसको zero बोल देते हैं. Now if I increase the height of the body, we say its potential energy is increasing. ऐसा बोलते कि नहीं बोलते? That statement is wrong. When I say that this body is raised to a height h, it is not the potential energy of this mass which is increasing. It is the potential energy of the mass, okay, this is test mass plus Earth, which forms a system, is increasing. It is not of that this particular mass alone that energy is attributed to. Okay, so काफी बच्चों को common misconception रहता है, so I thought I'll clarify. That same thing is extended here. Okay, it is for the charge field system. Potential energy is for the charge field system. Now let me take you to the next slide. Okay, now for some calculation ease, what we do is that we choose a point at which the electric field is zero. That means it is a region of space where the distance of the charges from that particular region is almost infinite. such that the charges produce insignificant electric field, or almost you can say there is no electric field in that region of space. So that particular region of space is conveniently taken as a reference having potential energy zero, or potential of that point as zero. So when I say infinity, I am basically referring to a region where the electric field is zero. There are no electrical effects. So when you bring in a charge from that convenient point, which is infinity, to that particular point in space where electric field exists, then the work done by that external agent will be increasing or decreasing the potential energy of the system. And if you calculate that work done per unit charge, then that will be defined as a potential of that point. So what you have to remember is that if you wish to find out the potential of a point, absolute potential of a point, then one of the limits has to be taken from infinity. Okay. So that is what is being explained here. If this A is infinity, where the potential is zero, then if I calculate it by this expression, E dot ds infinity to point P, then I get the potential of point P. Is this clear? So even this Vp is potential difference only. It is the potential difference of point P minus potential difference of a point infinity at infinite separation. And this value is, for our convenience purpose, we have taken this to be zero. Okay, so this entire thing is explained in this sheet. Just write it down, everything, and try to understand. I'll give you 2-3 minutes to write everything. Now this Vp that we calculated, with one point being at infinity, another point on the limits is taken as P, it gives you the absolute potential of point P. But it is representing nothing but the potential difference. In reality, it is nothing but the potential difference. The other convenient point that we have chosen is such that वहाँ का potential zero है, इसलिए it gives the potential of this point. But you will come across situations where the potential will not be infinite, it will not be zero at infinity. Okay, so we'll deal with these cases from next class onwards. So in some of the situations, absolute potential will not be defined, but potential difference will be defined, right? So we will look at those kind of problems from the next class onwards. But you should keep in mind that maybe at infinity, potential is not zero, not always. Okay, now let's look at the definition aspect of it. Electric potential is a measure of the potential energy per unit charge. In terms of unit, it can be written as joule per coulomb, work done per unit charge, that is joules per coulomb. So 1 volt can also be defined as 1 joule of work must be done to move a 1 coulomb charge through a potential difference of 1 volt. So this is an alternative way of defining 1 joule of work done, right? In terms of electric field also, it can be written as electric field is Newton per coulomb, can also be written as volts per meter. Okay, write this down. Okay, so I hope abhi kisi ko doubt nahi hai. We have 2 minutes left. Let's write this down very fast. It is about electron volt, which is an alternate unit of energy, which will be used mostly in atomic and nuclear physics calculation. The term is electron volt, which basically means that if one electron charge is moved across a potential difference of 1 volt, it either gains or loses 1 electron volt of energy. Okay. So this is nothing but the restatement of the definition of energy in the case of a specific case of a charge having charge on it equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. तो अगर मैं इस चार्ज को मूव करूंगा अक्रॉस 1 वोल्ट तो इट विल गेन एनर्जी इक्विवेलेंट टू 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, ठीक है ना. तो इन टर्म्स ऑफ द मैग्नीट्यूड 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट इज इक्वल टू 1.6 इनटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 19 जूल्स. दिस इज जूल, दिस इज इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. ओके, सो वन एग्जांपल इज गिवन. Okay, it's a practical example wherein electron in the beam of a typical television picture tube, जो पुराने जमाने में picture tube होती थी, उसमें electron beam को हम लोग project करते थे. तो उसकी speed was very close to the speed of light, 1/10 of the speed of light. So that energy is equivalent to 5.6 into 10 to the power minus 16 joule. In terms of electron volt, it will be 3.5 into 10 to the power 3 electron volt. Which basically means that you need 3.5 kilovolt of potential difference to accelerate it. Okay, if you wish to gain that kind of energy, you have to accelerate the electron through a potential difference of 3.5 kilo electron volt. Okay, now you can write this down fatafat because this session might end in any time.